Hey guys, and welcome to this vlog. It's gonna be a like apartment touring vlog. So I went on several apartment tours with one of my roommates right now to figure out where we're going to live next year for our second year of dental school in San Francisco. So I just wanted to like take you guys along on this journey and show you guys like the types of apartments we looked at and like what the price range was like for certain apartments, and then I'll reveal which one we chose at the very end, and then I'll probably post some moving vlogs after that. I really want to buy like a nicer camera to get higher quality, but we'll see what happens, if it happens before the moving vlogs or not. But I'm excited for you guys to see what the San Francisco apartments are like, especially in the area that we were looking at. Stay tuned and I'll give you guys a little bit of a description of like each apartment. So here is apartment number one, and look how beautiful this kitchen is. The best part about this apartment was the view. I was in love with the view so much. I wish I could live at this one. It's located right in Mission Bay and you can see the port right there. And it had a very nice balcony that was overlooking the water, which was just a dream. And then over into the bedroom, it had one wall that was just a cement wall. So it was a very up-to-date look. The one issue with this apartment was that it was just way out of our budget. So here is apartment number two, and it was a very large unit located in Soma. It was going for two bed, two bath for $3,200, which is extremely cheap for this size, and especially in San Francisco for a two bedroom. Me and Janet really, really liked this one. It had so much space. I personally was not a big fan of the yellow walls, but I did like the sliding doors. It gave it a very artistic feel. It did need some closet space, so that was not installed. And then it didn't have a washer dryer unit, so that was a bit of an issue, but we were definitely looking into this one as one of our options. And here's just a little bit of an overview. Another thing to add about this unit was that there was no security located, and it seemed a little bit easy to get in from the street, so safety was a little bit of an issue that we were thinking about unless we were on a higher floor. Also with packages, they were kind of just thrown like at the front, so anyone could kind of steal your things, and it didn't feel very safe. Here is apartment number three. We actually looked at, I think, four units in this complex, and there were two buildings. We looked at a two bed, two bath, and it was very spacious. I think the best part was the living area. The rooms were a bit small, but it did have a lot of closet space, and the rooms were on opposite sides of the apartment, which gave some privacy, and that was nice. But look at this view. It was just gorgeous. It was like everything you want and more. And it was located in Mission Bay. Looking at the view and everything you get from this building, it was a bit out of our price range. I believe it was around $4,600 to $4,700 for this unit, and our budget was kind of $4,000. Here's another one of the apartments, which was cheaper in the same building, but it was fully carpeted and it didn't have as much space, especially in the kitchen. The cupboards were just smaller. Everything was just a little smaller and outdated, which was fine and we were okay with that, but it was still above $4,000. I think it was $4,200, and the unit did have a lot of amenities such as like a basketball court and a gym. I think they had a gym in like two of the buildings out of three. And yeah, all of the units had a lot of closet space, which was definitely nice. Now on to apartment number 5, also in the same complex. This one was also on the older side, but it had a lot more counter space in the kitchen, and we really liked that. It also had same 2-bed, 2-bath style, same amenities. It was still a little overpriced, I believe $4,300 to $4,400 to live in this building. Here is apartment number 6 in the same complex, and it's definitely one of the nicer ones with a lot of space, and it has a full-size bathroom, same as the other 2-bed, 2-bath, a pretty small bedroom, but it does have large windows, and lighting was really important for me, so I was definitely taking that into consideration, especially in the living room. This corner unit had really great views of Mission Bay and the water outside. It was very nice, but a little out of price range, just like the others, but we still wanted to look into it just in case. Here's apartment number 7. It was definitely older. Everything was kind of outdated. Everything was carpeted. 2-bed, 2-bath. This was more within our price range. It was under $4,000, but it was being rented out by landlords. So a little different than the other complexes that we had looked at. This is the second bedroom with the closets. And then it also had a lot of good lighting, which was nice. So that was a plus. And then the primary bedroom had 4 closets, so a lot of storage, really great lighting, lots of space, some windowsill seating as well. And then a bathroom with a separate bathtub and separate shower. So here is apartment number 8 and the last apartment that we had toured. This one is located in Knob Hill and it's a 2-bed, 1-bath. This bathroom is very cute and new, seemed like it was newly renovated. This apartment had a very San Francisco feel to it, which I definitely liked, and the living room seemed to have gotten a lot of light. There was definitely a lot of street noise, but I feel like we're kind of used to that at this point. This was the main bedroom, and it had its own closet with a lot of storage. And then there was a sliding door from that bedroom to the living room. And then the second bedroom was a bit on the smaller side and it was not getting as much light. In the video, it seems like it's more light, but in person, it was very dark.
Which apartment did you guys think that we chose? If you're wondering, we chose apartment number 8, and we chose it because it has the price per square footage. It was honestly within our budget, and we got a lot more space than our previous apartment. And I'll give you guys a little bit of some moving vlogs later on. I just wanted to upload this before the moving vlog. So you guys could get a little bit of an idea of the apartments in San Francisco.